So we take eggs from the landlocked salmon here on our large lakes because we do not have a broodstock line in our hatchery system. So we have to trap the wild salmon in the lake to collect their eggs and milk and spawn them artificially to continue the program. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to maintain a landlocked salmon fishery here in our big lakes. In the fall, this is the time when salmon spawn. Normally, salmon need a large river to spawn in, all right? And since our lakes that we have in New Hampshire don't have the large river habitat, they're still attracted to flowing water. So they'll try to find any little stream or river that does flow in. So this is where we set our nets to trap the salmon that are coming into the shallows along the shoreline, and we intercept them before they get to any of the little streams. The eggs are stripped from the females and the milk from the males are mixed together right on the site where we do our egg collections on the shoreline of one of our big lakes here. Eventually, they're put in little coolers, and this can be up to like 120,000 eggs that we collect yearly. And these fertilized eggs now are transported to one of our hatcheries, and they're incubated there through the winter until they hatch out. They remain in the hatcheries until they're about a year old, and then we stock them back out into the lakes that are supporting the salmon population. Atlantic salmon, unlike Pacific salmon, will spawn multiple times in their lifetime. The fish are very much alive after we strip the eggs from them, and we release them, you know, basically back at the site we're taking the eggs from them, where the fish were trapped in our trap net. So that's the neat thing about Atlantics, that they'll continuously, you know, spawn year after year.